Hi guys, how are you? Hope you are doing fine and that you are safe. So I decided to film a birthday haul, but it's going to be a two-part video, hopefully, because I'm still waiting for one perfume and I tend to make too long videos, so I decided not just to split them and to do a birthday gift haul, if it's a thing, I don't know, I mean, to include only the perfumes that were gifted to me, and another part of the haul where I present you the perfumes that I bought for myself, because yes, it's my birthday, right? Hopefully at least one of these videos I will upload during this week when it's actually my birthday. Yay, happy birthday to me. So I'm a Leo, and we are known to be modest beings, you know, we don't make a fuss around our birthdays, right? If you are a Leo or you have met at least one Leo in your lifetime, you know what I'm saying. But let's just get into the perfumes that I received as gifts for my birthday. This year I decided I'm not going to celebrate much my birthday because a lot of factors, but my friends and my family decided to be very generous with me, so I received gorgeous gifts, perfume gifts, from my wish list and so on. So let's start with one that actually at first, let's place it in its box, I ordered for myself, but my husband decided it's going to be part of his gift for me, and this is Mon Parfum Cristal from Martin Mikalev, my first purchase made directly from the Mikalev website, and I'm very happy with the fact that even for such a small purchase, so this is a 30 milliliter bottle and it was on sale, 38 euros if I'm not mistaken, so it was the retail price is around 90 or 95 euros, so a big discount for this one. And even for such a small purchase, 38 euros, they offered free engraving on the bottle. So I decided to put fragrant lily. I wanted this to be like a souvenir, you know, to remember the time when I had this channel. I don't know if in a few years I'm going to keep on doing the stuff that I'm doing now on this channel or if not. And anyway, this will be a great souvenir of this experience of having this channel, of having all these beautiful comments, discussions with you regarding perfumes, and yes, I wanted to have a memory of this great period of my life. How does it smell? Mon Parfum Cristal. So, this is sweet. A sweet rose. I'm not that much into sweet rose scents. And I had to decide between this one and Mon Parfum. That is a more patchouli combination, you know, passion fruit patchouli combination. I'm much more into patchouli. I didn't know any of these two, so this is a blind buy, a blind gift, if I dare say. But I saw a lot of great reviews regarding this. One was of Chantel's. She had a great personal, you know, experience with the scent, and it kind of made me buy it. And I don't regret it because it is not what, I mean, it is what I expected, but not quite so. So it is more my style than I was expecting it to be. The name Cristal is very well chosen for this scent, because this is the feeling that you get. The sweetness in here is like the ones, you know, when you have those hard candies. So imagine some rose hard candies, but also with some herbal feeling to them. This is not just sweet, it's sweet, bitter, sweet herbal. And the feeling when you crunch them, you know, it's like glass, like crystal. And also the sweetness is not that cloying. So imagine something that is also like, has like a cooling effect. Okay, not warm, but rather cool. And yes, I even like it now when it's hot outside. So, who would have thought? I thought it was more like a winter sand, but it works beautifully. So, I'm feeling it right now around me. It smells gorgeous. It is a little bit sweet. I mean, I'm not that much into sweet, sweet scents, but it's also elegant and airy, not cloying. I like it a lot. I don't know much about its performance. I'm going to test it more in cooler weather. And unfortunately, or fortunately, almost all my gifts are better suited for cooler weather. So bear in mind that if I'm not going to be able, to discuss much about their performance right now in summertime. Adore this fragrant lily engraving, and I think this is a very nice service, that they are providing to such a small purchase to have the possibility, to put your name here. Lovely. I paid 12 euros for the transport because of the value, and I regret not buying also Mon Parfum, because if I bought the two, that one was also on sale and it was 38 euros, and I would have had transport included and only paid like 20 something, 26, 25 euros extra for two of these. Yes, now I'm regretting it, but that's it. I don't know what I was thinking. I said to myself, you don't need both, just choose one. Anyway, so yes, from Martin Mikhalev, Mon Parfum Cristal, very happy that I have this one in my collection now, thanks to my husband also. Then let's go into my next purchase, and this one was on my list for some time. My friends, my mother decided, they are going to give to me this perfume. And you already know, if you watched my video about sexy perfumes, the one that I made with my husband, this is Rosendo Mathieu number 5. And this was in the top, I think top 4 at least, of sexy perfumes voted. This is the bottle. This is called Floral Amber Sandalwood Musk, and this is how it smells. Okay. This smells much better on your skin than in the air or on the blotter. Please keep that in mind if you are going to test this one. How does it smell? So I am not feeling the florals. I'm not smelling the florals. Maybe because of the season. Because this is more suitable for colder weather, like my husband said, and for nighttime maybe. I do smell a lot of spiciness, spices. And I smell the musk and the amber. I really like the combination. My husband says it kind of reminds him of Arabic perfumes. I don't mean oriental perfumes that are done in a westernized manner, but more like the ones that he smelled during his trip to Dubai, for example, okay? But I can't say that I feel the same. I mean, it doesn't smell like anything else to me right now that I have experienced. I can't associate it myself with something right now, maybe in time after wearing it a few times. What I can say is that I tested it when I received it, and I really enjoyed it. But I also wore it 2 days ago when it was really hot, and the experience was not that nice. I mean, I think definitely this is something for cooler weather. So if you are testing it for the first time, do it in a space with air conditioning at least, or during the colder season. This would be my suggestion. However, it smells beautiful. It stays a long time on your skin when you test it, when you are testing it in the right environment. And definitely I need to try it more and on different occasions. But my husband said it smells sexy. I know, it was much raved online. It's becoming more and more hyped, I think, by Noelle from I Am Noelle by Phoenix, that I recently discovered her channel. I really like her, Charlie Phoenix, and I understand why. So men, my husband at least, find this to be sexy. Now, another gift from my husband. Lune Feline by Atelier des Ors. I really wanted to try this one first, but it was not available for me to test it before, so it was a blind gift, blind buy, because it popped up in on one of my Facebook groups that I'm watching, and the price was great. I mean, 120 euros. If I'm not mistaken, for a 100 milliliter bottle, and if you know the prices for this, this is a good price, and it was just tested by the person, so full bottle. This is how it comes, the presentation. So you have that sleeve, okay, that comes off, and then you have the box with the bottle inside. The only thing that I don't like is that for my bottle, the cap doesn't stay very well. I don't know why. And this is the bottle. Okay, can do like this. And I'm a Leo. So I am mesmerized with the gold flakes from this bottle, but also with the scent. So, just to make you laugh a little bit, as I have said, I didn't have the opportunity to test it first. It was a blind buy. To make an idea how this would smell, because I have seen so many comments that it smelled like burnt rubber and so on and so forth. But basically, they say, all said that it smells a lot like cardamom and vanilla. So I had a body lotion from Victoria's Secret that smells like vanilla. I layered it with some cardamom dusting, because I do have cardamom in my spice box. And I went like this and smelled my hand. I was at home, at least, because my hand looked like it had dirt on it. You know, the color of cardamom together with vanilla. Cream, yes, but it gave me an idea, but a small, very small part. So just a small idea of how this scent would smell, and I decided that I like the combination. I like cardamom fragrances. I have Memoir from Mamouage, and I think I have cardamom in other spice, in other fragrances, but I can't remember right now the ones that I have. And yes, I decided let's go for it, and I'm very happy. I sprayed it on my hand earlier. It is sweet, it is smoky, it is spicy. It does have some smokiness, but on me it doesn't smell like burnt rubber. However, please keep in mind that others and other YouTubers had this experience with it, that they smelled like something burning and they were not very happy. But this is in the top notes. And what I find interesting is that after a while, after a few wears, the top notes are not so strong. I don't know if you experience this in perfumes, but I do. I mean, if a perfume has something in the top notes that bothers me at first, after a few wears, I'm becoming more comfortable and I'm not feeling it as much, especially if I like the dry down of the perfume. I hope it helps my short review. Maybe I will do another review of the scent when fall comes and I'm going to give it more wear, because right now it's too hot for it, even for me. And I do like my Orientals, but this one, it is a little bit, because it is a warm perfume, you know, it gives you a very warm, beautiful aura around you, and it works better in colder weather, I think. And now, the last but not least of my gifts, this perfume was gifted to me by our future godchildren. I don't know if I'm saying it right. I mean, we are going to be like the spiritual parents when they are getting married in church. Okay, let's say that. Okay, so they gifted me this gorgeous scent. This is Amouage Journey. This is the box. And this is the beautiful bottle. This is absolutely gorgeous. I adore all Amouage bottles, but this is absolutely gorgeous. And the scent is absolutely gorgeous. And this one, actually, I tested it before. I knew I wanted it. It was on my wish list, and they wanted to make this gift to me. Very generous of them. I mean, it is a big gift, and I appreciate it a lot. And this one, this from all of them, I think is the one that I can wear any season, even if it is a little bit on the spicy side and more suitable for colder weather. This I can wear even during cooler nights now in summertime. And it is a beautiful, let me just spray it on my hand. Honey osmanthus, you have nutmeg and other spices. The osmanthus, if you are familiar with some scents that have osmanthus in it, in them smells like apricots, but also has like a leathery undertone, like suede leather. It is sweet. And a few years back, or was it last year? I don't remember exactly. I had a small decant of this one, and actually I didn't like it that much. It turned too sweet on my skin. I don't know, something was off-putting. I set it aside, and then I saw it on a Facebook group that it was much raved by a few girls, that they loved it. And now I understand it's been discontinued, unfortunately. That's not okay, because it is a beautiful scent. And after I saw it so much raved, you know, I decided to find my decant and give it another try. And after I tried it some more, I realized that they actually loved it. And I like it more than another Amouage that it is in my collection, but, and that one was hyped. It has also osmanthus in it, but I much prefer this one. Actually, I'm going to do, I think, soon, I don't know when, but soon, an Amouage video. So a video dedicated to my Amouage scents. Please let me know if you want to see something like this. I have a few. I really like this brand, and I'm kind of collecting them. They are beautiful. They are special. Not everybody is a fan of their scents, and I understand why. They are a little bit on the difficult side, some of them. This one, to me, is one of the most wearable, definitely. I mean, at least to me, it could definitely be a signature scent for somebody, because it works for daytime, nighttime, all occasions. Yes, beautiful, spicy, sweet, but not too sweet, not as sweet as I used to think. More on the spicy side. So apricots, spiced up apricots, some florals, some white tobacco, if I'm not mistaken in it. Complex, special. This was my birthday haul, my gifts that I received this birthday. When is your birthday? What gifts did you receive? Or what perfumes are you on your wish list for your birthday? Please let me know in the comments area. And if you like this video, please give me a thumbs up. Please subscribe to my channel and don't forget to hit the notification bell. Bye bye. Stay safe.